The Gila National Forest is a special place. In 1924, a young forester by the name of Aldo Leopold set this land aside to be the first officially designated wilderness in the United States and in the world. And 40 years after that, we were able to have the passage of the Wilderness Act in 1964, codifying this as an official code and land management tool.
There are no roads allowed in wilderness. There are no motors allowed in wilderness, no mechanized travel. It's a place where we can really relax and slow down and escape from the stressors and the pace of the modern world.
He was a bit of a radical back in 1924. He was a young forester who had an idea to make land that was specifically to be conserved and specifically for recreation in a time period where those sort of ideas did not exist yet. He's known for waking up at 4 a.m. to watch the different species of birds wake up one by one, identify their different calls, and just drink a coffee with his dog on the porch while the world around him would come to life. And it was those kind of experiences that helped him understand the complexities of the world and the importance in protecting them. And the Gila became the first wilderness because they were planning on putting a road in it, and in a way that would be seen as disruptive to the natural ecosystem and processes that they had there. And he took it upon himself to protect an area where he really cherished as a space of recreation and as a space for wild things to be free.
In my mind, Aldo Leopold's vision was to save large tracts of land that weren't adversely affected by man. And I think when managing 500,000 acres of wilderness, we're hanging on to his ideas, you know, and using primitive tools, horses, cross-cut saws, you know, packing all the tools that we need. I think that's staying in his vision.
What we're marking here is 100-year anniversary of that dedication to this land and of Leopold deciding that this is a special place and going forward with a radical solution to protect it. Wilderness is very much alive in 2024, 100 years after its initial designation as wilderness. And to the extent possible, that land has not changed. It has been free from human development and interference since its inauguration in 1924.
You might think in our modern society, we tend to separate ourselves from wild places and experiences. And I think it's really important to kind of look at that from a more holistic perspective.
So wilderness is a really special designation, and especially the Gila Wilderness. We're sitting on one of the larger swaths of wilderness in the lower 48 states. And one of Leopold's original visions for what he could use to define this type of land is a space under which you could have a 2-week pack trip without having to experience any sort of human development.
To be in a more remote setting with just more rugged terrain and different landscapes is really special, and you just get to see a variety of things while you're out.
There is tension within the rules of what wilderness is. We want it to be both undeveloped and untrammeled and also provide a lovely experience for recreation. We want the public to both be able to access wilderness and also keep it as a space of solitude. A lot of the beauty lies in these contradictions and understanding what it is, and both allowing it to exist for the land and allowing it to exist for the people.